Minister made a point about the standards of journalism. It's not a simple issue to address in the course of a ministerial statement, but my generation at least remember this headline, this cover page in the new paper, which was in 1997, at a very sensitive time, just during the elections, and it was a checklist to help you decide how to vote. Minister spoke earlier about objectivity and balance. The only thing objective about this cover page is the EPL scores, no win for Liverpool and also for Manchester United. The checklist essentially told the voters what you're voting for. If you vote for the PAP, you're voting for upgrading EduSafe and MPs of acceptable character.
Mr. Singh, if I could ask you to seek your clarification rather than expound in a speech. Thank you.
I will come to that, Deputy Speaker. Thank you, and I'll be brief. But I would agree with the Minister to the extent that one has to be fair to the journalists, because they are good journalists. And a good example is on the 1st of May this year, the Chinese media group head of Zhaopao, Li Hui Ling, she asked some very serious questions about the leadership transition between to the 4G leadership. And she said internal competition is intense. There's no consensus to pick anyone. And on the other hand, the English papers, major cabinet reshuffle, but now is not the time to read the tea leaves. So there can be different views on the quality and the standards of journalism. And it is for that reason that I put my earlier question to the minister about a select committee and to try and get some understanding from the public what they expect of a taxpayer-funded CLG. I note the comment Minister made about the surveys, but I think this is an opportunity to hear from the public, and I hope the government can consider this favourably.
Mr. Deputy Speaker, I'm disappointed that the Leader of the Opposition has decided to make political capital out of something that I think is quite fundamentally important to us. And I think even in the examples that he cites, in a way, he has already illustrated the point that I'm making. He went back to 1997 to bring out an example, and then he says, just last year, the Chinese media put forward one, or this year, Chinese media put one point of view, and the English media put another point of view. Isn't this the diversity that we want? Isn't it the diversity that the Leader of the Opposition has been talking about? So I am not very clear why he thinks the current model is not succeeding. Is it perfect? No. I would challenge him to show me a model that works and that is perfect. But is it one that works in our context? I think it does, with some areas for improvement, certainly, but it's an evolutionary process. And even in the examples that the leader cites, I think it's quite clear. And I would add that what we want at the end of the day is not posturing, but substance. So if we can achieve that, not just in the news media, but also in this chamber, I think we would have gone a long way to building a stronger country and nation.